God, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My sisters and brothers, let us acknowledge all sins and deliver our vows at the Son of Jesus. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have been so sinned, in my thoughts and my words, in what I have done, and what I have yet to do. Through my most grievous fault, therefore I ask blessed to your Lord, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us all sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And let us pray. O God, whose only begotten Son, the trust of Mary Magdalene before all others, who have announcing the great joy of the resurrection, grant me, pray, that through her intercession and example, we may proclaim the living Christ and come to see him reigning in your glory, who lives and reigns with you with the Holy Spirit, one God, ever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you.
On the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb early in the morning while it was still dark, and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and said to the other disciple whom Jesus loved and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we do not know where they put him." Mary stayed outside the tomb weeping, and as she went, she went over into the tomb and They have taken my Lord, and I do not know where they hid him. When she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus there, but did not know it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" She thought it was the gardener and said to him, "Sir, if you carried him away, tell me where you laid him, and I will take him." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabbi," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Stop holding on to me, for I have yet ascended to the Father. But go to my brothers and tell them, I am going to my Father, your Father, to my God and your God." Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord," and then reported what he told them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you.
For Holy Church, we pray that God continues to give us strength to continue to proclaim His word, to continue to bring this message and bring that tidings to the poor. We pray to the Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for your goodness receive the bread we offer you, the fruit of the offer of human hands, become for us the bread of life. And by the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share the divinity of Christ. who humbled himself to shed our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for you have received the wine we offer you, through the divine work in the hands become our spiritual drink. With humble spirit and contrite heart, may be accepted by your Lord, and may your sacrifice of sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, Lord, from iniquity, that it be for my sin. And pray, my friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, the offerings presented in commemoration of St. Mary Magdalene, whose homage of charity was graciously accepted by the only begotten Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and ever, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, true Christ our Lord. For in the marvelous confession of your saints, you make your church fruitful with strength ever new, and offer our sure signs of your love. And you, that your saving mysteries may be fulfilled, that in example we lend us courage, that fervent prayer sustain us in all we do. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as an exaltation. We inflame.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the Father of all holiness. Make holy that for these gifts we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon it like a dewfall, so that it may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and submitted into his passion, he took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper ended, he took the chalice after giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which you pour out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks to God as worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we gather into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring up to the fullness of charity together Francis our Pope, George our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who fall asleep, hope for the resurrection, and all who died in your mercy. Remember especially Todd Cohen, for whom this marks his offer. Welcome them to the light of your face, have mercy on us all, we pray. That the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who please you throughout the ages, we grant before us eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him, and O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor to yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and all the divine teaching, we bear and say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. given to us hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look now that thou sinnest on the faith of your church, and graciously grant the peace and unity in the common of your will, the living and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, and behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy of the creation that is under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. And may the body and blood of Christ be a safe way to the life.
Love of Christ who knows us, so that
instill in us that persevering love with which St. Mary Magdalene clung resolutely to Christ, our Master, who lives and reigns ever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. May Almighty God bless you, Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Have a good day.